Hello students, today we are going to learn about a new type of battery, that is a lithium polymer battery. So this is a lithium polymer battery. Okay, in the last session we have seen about lithium ion batteries. So what is the difference between this battery and lithium ion battery? So the simple difference is, in both the batteries, same principle is used, but the electrolyte was a liquid. So these batteries does not contain liquid electrolyte. Instead of liquid, they have a gel type electrolyte that is made up of a polymer. Polyethylene oxide is a polymer that is used as electrolyte in this battery. So these batteries are very small in size, yet these batteries can provide more power than lithium ion batteries. So lithium polymer batteries are used in many applications where weight is a main problem. So these batteries are used in aircrafts that are radio controlled device. So these aircrafts are very lightweight, so these aircrafts need these batteries so that the weight of the aircraft is very low. This is also used in drones. So the weight is the main parameter in some applications. So these batteries are also used in Bluetooth headsets. So we can recharge them, and this is very lightweight and we can use it in many applications. Okay children, if we compare the size of this battery with a lithium ion battery, so this is a lithium ion battery. This battery and this battery are very small in size, but when compared with this battery, the lithium polymer battery is very small in size, but the power produced by both the batteries are same. So this is the specialty of lithium polymer battery. So what is the necessary to increase the size of the battery or to decrease the size of the battery? So these batteries are very costly just because the size is very small. So we cannot make batteries that are very huge in size for some applications. So for some applications, we need batteries that are very small in size and yet we need more power. So in that applications, we use this lithium polymer batteries. So these batteries are very costly. So these batteries contain a small circuit. Why it has a small circuit? Because the nominal voltage, that is the working voltage of this battery, is 3.6 to 3.7 volt. But if this battery is fully charged, then the maximum voltage will be 4.2 volt. And if the battery is fully discharged, the maximum voltage should be 2.7 to 3 volt. Okay. If we discharge this battery anymore, that is, if the battery's voltage reduces below 2.7 volt, then the battery will become unusable. That is, we cannot recharge them again. So in order to prevent the degradation of this battery, and we have to improve the life of this battery, so that we are using a small circuit over here. Okay. So this circuit, okay, can you see a small circuit over here? So this circuit is used to provide a control unit. So this control unit can control the voltage of this battery. So even though if we charge this battery for a longer time, the battery will not charge anymore once the full charge is attained. And similarly, if we use this battery continuously for a longer time, if the battery voltage level is being reduced to a certain point, that is 2.7 volt. After that, the battery will not provide any more voltage. So this thing is controlled by the circuit. So the battery's voltage will be maintained at 2.7 volt to 4.2 volt so that this battery's life can be increased and this battery will be used for a longer time. Students, in the next session, we will learn about the size of batteries and why some batteries are larger in size and some batteries are smaller in size. So we will learn about the capacity and the size of batteries. Okay, children, we will meet in the next session. Thank you.